Scapula is a triangular shaped bone placed on the posterolateral aspect of the thoracic cage. It comprises two surfaces. The scapula comprises of two surfaces, three borders, three angles, three fossae, and three processes, and spine. Surfaces. Dorsal surface shows a prominent spine of scapula. Ventral surface is concave. Borders. Upper border is small, containing a suprascapular notch towards the lateral side. Medial border is longer, thin, and lies between the upper and inferior angles. Lateral border is thickest between the large lateral angle, the glenoid cavity, and the inferior angle. Angles. Lateral angle is surmounted by a large concave glenoid cavity for articulation with the rounded head of humerus to form the most mobile shoulder joint. The mobility can be seen in a fast bowler. The mobility can be seen in a fast bowler like Kapil Dev. Inferior angle forms the apex of the triangular shaped scapula. Processes. On the upper border, just above the suprascapular notch, is a beak-like coracoid process. On the dorsal surface of scapula is a raised projection, the spine of scapula. It comprises an upper surface, a lower surface, and a free border. Continuation of spine of scapula is the acromion process with a free lateral border. It also has a clavicular notch for articulation with the lateral end of the clavicle. Fossae. Spine of scapula divides the dorsal surface into an upper, smaller, supraspinous fossa and a lower, larger, infraspinous fossa. The costal or ventral surface is concave and is called subscapular fossa. It shows 3 to 4 ridges. Side identification. Dorsal surface with the spine to be placed dorsally. Inferior angle to be put downwards. Lateral angle with glenoid cavity to be placed laterally.
Good.
Scapula comprises two surfaces, three borders, three angles, three fossae, and three processes. Surfaces. Dorsal surface shows a prominent spine of scapula. Ventral surface is concave. Borders. The upper border is small, containing a suprascapular notch towards lateral side. Medial border is long, thin, and lies between the upper and inferior angles. Lateral border is thickest between the large lateral angle, the glenoid cavity, and the inferior angle. Angles. Lateral angle is surmounted by a large concave glenoid cavity for articulation with the rounded head of humerus to form the most mobile shoulder joint. Processes. On the upper border, just above the suprascapular notch, is a beak-like coracoid process. On the dorsal surface of scapula is a raised projection, the spine of scapula. It comprises an upper surface, lower surface, and a free border. Continuation of spine of scapula is the acromion process with a free lateral border. It also has an attachment for the lateral end of the clavicle. Fossae. Spine of scapula divides the dorsal surface into an upper, smaller, supraspinous fossa and a lower, larger, infraspinous fossa. The costal or ventral surface is concave and is called subscapular fossa. It shows 3 to 4 ridges. Side identification. Dorsal surface with the spine to be placed dorsally. Inferior angle to be put downwards and lateral angle with glenoid cavity to be placed laterally.